limitations. He has developed the following lab-scale projects relevant to the power electronic circuit for EV charging: 1 kW DC to DC converter for PV and EV interface, 1 kW HAR lithium-ion battery pack model, intelligent IoT controller for electric vehicle interface, retrofitted EV model. Sir, I may call upon you for the presentation.
Thank you, Ankit. Okay. Good morning to all. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Okay. With the continuation of the previous session, we will simulate the boost converter and buck converter and buck boost converter. Okay. Before designing, I want to discuss with you few concept. Okay, like when we need a boost converter, when we need a buck converter, when we need a combination of this, then what will happen, the voltage, what will happen, the current, that and all we need to discuss. That I will discuss with you now. Okay, for example, if you are considering this circuit, this is a boost converter circuit. If you're considering this circuit, okay, for example, if I want to charge a battery of, once, if I want to charge a battery of 12 volt, okay, I have a PV panel with 5 volt, 5 watt PV panel. Then what will happen, the voltage and current, what is the amount of voltage, then amount of current I will get it from the PV panel when I'm using a boost converter. That we need to discuss. Then we will analyze the same thing in MATLAB. Then if you're coming to this, the power equal to V into I, by considering this equation, this DC equation, then we will find the current. The current equal to 1 ampere. Then based on the circuit operation, what is the amount of current we will receive? Here we will provide 5 volt. The across the capacitor, okay, we will receive the 12 volt across the load. Then by considering this concept, we will get a current of the output current. Input current we are giving as 1 ampere. The output current of the 5 volt we are giving, then the voltage is output of the, sorry, 5 watt we are giving. The output voltage required for the battery is 12 volt. Then the current is unknown. What is the current we will receive? That we need to check. If you calculate this one, we will get a current around 0.4 ampere. This much amount of current we will get it in the boost converter. What will happen while we are boosting the voltage? Okay, we are using a 5 watt PV panel. We will get 5 watt output if there is no losses in the converter. If there is no losses in the converter, we will get 5 watt. Otherwise, based on the efficiency of the converter, the output values will vary. Instead of 5 watt, we will get less than that. We will get. Okay, here the current, what is happening in the current? The current we are providing here is 1 ampere, approximately 0.4 ampere we will get it across the battery. Okay, while voltage is increasing, the current will be decreasing. This will be vice versa in the buck converter. Okay, when we need a combination of this, okay, this is about a boost converter. We need this boost converter for this arrangement. Okay, then if you're coming to the buck converter, this arrangement in the buck converter. Okay, similarly, okay, the current will be high, current will be high, that here the current will be decreasing in the buck converter. If you are coming to the buck boost converter, then we need this combination of buck boost converters. If you are considering a PV as application, okay, we will say 12 volt. Okay, all the time it is not boosting the values. Okay, sometimes it will boost when there is a radiation. Okay, when there is a cloud formation above the PV, the voltage will decrease. The voltage will decrease. That time also it is boosting, or sometimes but the voltage is increasing. While increasing the voltage, we need to maintain a constant of 12 volt. Based on the, there is a dynamic variation in the input. Okay, when there is a PV or wind, in this case and all, we need a buck boost converter. This type of buck boost converter can be used for the applications, real-time application. Then if you're coming to the design, okay, we need to set the values of load. Okay, as we know, our requirement, okay, whether I'm going to connect the LED or battery, which one I'm going to connect, whether it's energy storage devices, which one I'm going to connect with the my converter. Okay, based on that, what is the charging current? If it is a battery, we need to check the charging current. What is my charging current? What is my C rating of the battery? Based on that, I need to design a converter. What is the current rate I need to design? Based on that, voltage and current will be provided. Then based on that, we will choose the input. Okay, then if you're designing a transfer function, based on the boost converter transfer function, we will design the parameters of the boost converters. Like, okay, I've taken values from the textbooks. Okay, this is the design available in the textbooks. You can refer, okay, even if whatever sir is discussed, by using the same mathematical model, you can derive the IOs. Okay, input is given to 12 volt. Then if I want to get a 20 volt, what are the component? What are the component requirement? That I'm presenting. I'm presenting here. This is inductor value of 76.86 microhenry. Then capacitance of 400 microfarad, resistance of 4 ohms, and switching frequency of 25 kilohertz, and duty cycle is 40%. This and all we need to select for the for achieving this output. Okay. The similarly, I've presented the values. If you want, you can note down these values. Anyway, I will, while I'm simulating also, I will feed these values in the MATLAB. Okay, now we will go to the MATLAB. Do you have any doubt in this till now? You can post it in chat window. At last, I will discuss with you. Now I will share my MATLAB screen. I'll be sharing my MATLAB screen. Is this visible to you? Okay, now we are going to perform this simulation in MATLAB Simile. Here, once you are opening MATLAB's software, here you can go to the new, which type of simulation you are going to perform. You are going to perform like a script or command or simulating project or simulating model. Here I'm going to use this simulating model for this boost converter simulation. Okay, what are the components are required? Okay, as we know, the boost converter, we required a component. One second. Okay, see, here we will select the component. Okay, then in the simulation window, we will select the component. I think my, okay, one second. It's not, I think it's not visible to you completely. Then, one second, I'll share my complete screen. Because only the MATLAB window is available for you, I will share the complete screen. One second, I will be sharing the complete screen. Okay, I'm finding the option to share the complete screen. One second. Now, this is visible to you. Then If you open the MATLAB simulation, okay, once again I'll explain to you. I'll close this because simulink model, you will open the simulink model. I'll keep this simulink model in the left hand side. Then I will click on the simulink model. There is a library browser. Okay, that here we will select the component. I will select the library browser. Then what are the components we need for the simulation, boost converter simulation. Okay, then here all the component will be selected from the SimScape and SimPower system. Then what is the basic component we need to choose for the simulation is, we need to select one MOSFET and one diode. Okay, here you can come to SimPower system. Here you can come to Power Electronics. In the Power Electronics, you can choose MOSFET or IGBT or BJT. Okay, we can go choose any type of devices. Okay, any switching devices we can use for the construction of boost converter or buck converter. Generally, the operating frequency, it will be operated in kilohertz or megahertz. The most suitable device for the boost converter is MOSFET. That I will select it. Then you can drag and drop it in your model, whatever the model you are creating. You can drag and drop it from the model, or otherwise you can right click on the device, okay, which component you are selecting, add to model. If you name this one, if you save this program in your MATLAB, okay, I will save this one. This is the boost converter. Okay. This one, boost converter. And save this one, boost converter. Then while you are selecting converter itself, which model you need to add this component. Here itself it will be. Then I will choose the next component. I will add the diode. Then what are the other requirements? Okay, here we need input source. We need the DC voltage source that we need to select. Then in the SIM power system itself, we will select the required component. We need to measure the voltage and current. We need to measure output voltage, and then input current and output current. This and all, okay, whether while it is increasing boosting value, what will happen your output current, that we need to measure. For that, I'm choosing one current measurement, one voltage measurement. Then if you're coming to the next one, next what and all we need. We need to select resistor and inductor and capacitor. Okay, we need to select a resistor. Individually, we need to select. Here, you can select. You can select RLC series branch. Okay, in the element, you can select RLC series branch. Okay, select RLC series branch itself. We can able to select. You can click on it. Then we are able to edit the required component. Then the first one, input we need to select. Then we need to select a DC input. For boost converter, we will be selecting DC input. Now we will try to connect the component which is available here. Okay, then we need a inductor, then we need a switch, we need a diode, also we need a capacitor and resistance. Okay, for selecting a capacitance, what you can do, you can press control and drag the component, select and drag the component. Then likewise, you can select three components. This is for inductance. Okay, this I will choose it for inductor. Okay, then next one, I will choose it for a capacitance. Next one, I will choose it for a resistance. I'll choose it for a resistance. The values and all we will edit it. Based on that, we will edit. Okay, this is a inductor. Okay, here you can edit the label also. Here you can edit the label also. This is a inductorial. This is a inductorial. Now you can select the inductorial. Then we can rotate the component. The components can be rotated based on the requirement. Generally, it is connected to the common source, like a source should be connected to the ground. Okay, here I will be rotating. In the MOSFET, I have a drain source, gate and measurement probe. These four probes are available. I think measurement is not required for this this one. I will disable this measurement. I will click on the device. I will disable the measurement probe. Then measurement will be disabled. Then I, what are the other terminals are required? These three terminals are required. Then I will rotate it based on the requirement. I will rotate it. Press select the component. Then you can press control and R simultaneously. Then it will get rotate. Now I need to connect this one. This drain will be connected to the inductor other end. The inductor other end will be connected to the DC input. Likewise, I will connect it, connect the source side also. Here, this portion is over. Then I need to connect a diode. Even in diode also, we don't want to connect a measurement. Even you can leave it, it's not a problem. If you don't want, you can eliminate the measurement probe. Now I will connect the diode. Then after that, I will connect the capacitor. Capacitor I will rotate by selecting control R. Okay, this is a capacitor. Then I need to connect a resistor also. Okay, these are the component we need to connect. I'll be connecting all the component with my for my boost converter. Okay, I've connected the component. Then we need a measurement, but I didn't connect the measurement. What is the input value? What is the output value? What is the input current? That we didn't connect. For that, we will connect a measurement probe, the voltage measurement and current measurement. Here we will connect the voltage measurement across the resistive load. We will measure the voltage, output voltage. Okay, we know the input voltage. We don't want to measure the input voltage. We don't want to measure the input voltage. Already we will set the input voltage here. Even if you want to measure the input voltage, you can connect one voltage measurement across the source. Here you can measure the voltage. Now we need to measure the current. Okay, the current we can measure here. Okay, in the input current, I will disconnect this portion. This current probe, will be connected in series. Okay, here I will be connecting this current probe. Think it's connected. Okay, it is connected. Now the current, it will measure the input current. Okay, I can write it as IP, input current. Okay, then we need to measure the output current also. Okay, for visibility, I will be increasing the size of the converter. Then I will measure the across the load. I will open this terminal. I will connect the ammeter here. Okay. Here, I'll press control. Then I will drag and drop it here. Then I will get a converter. Okay. Now we need to measure. Okay. We need to measure the output. Okay. We will display as a constant, or we will display as a waveform. Okay. If you are going for analysis. If we are, we want to analyze the waveform based on the input, how it is varying, then we need to select a scope. Okay, we can go to here, then Simulink. Here you can go to Sync. Then here you can select a scope. Okay. First of all, I will select a separate scope for voltage. Then input current as well as output current. I'll be connecting all the scope to measuring probe. Okay, current, input current, then this is a output. I will write IO. Okay, this will be I input. Okay, this is a voltage, output. This is a voltage output. Okay, now we connected all the components. Based on the design, we need to set the parameter value. What is the input voltage? Everything we need to set. Then one more terminal in the MOSFET is missing. That we need to select the, give it from the comparator. Either we can go for a comparator, or we can use a pulse generator also. If you are unable to find this component. You can type the component also. Okay. You type the component and search in the search window. Then you can add in your MATLAB model. Okay, I have selected the pulse generator. Even you can go for a comparator. Okay, you can have a triangular waveform and a square waveform. That you can make a comparator also. If already it's readily available, this is enough for your boost converter. Now we can set the parameter values. The inductance value I displayed over there is, okay, any of you doing, you can, if you have any difficulties in the construction, you can ask now itself. If not, I can continue. Okay, now 76.86 according to the taken values and design values, I'll take it. This inductor values are 76 microfarad. This I will select, then apply, then okay. Now, if you're coming to the capacitor, the capacitor value is 400 microfarad. Okay, here I will set 400 microfarad. By the double click on the device, I will select a 400 microfarad. The resistance value of 4 ohms. We need to choose based on the design only, we need to choose this value. Then pulse generator, what is the value we need to give it in the pulse generator? If it is a millisecond, we need to give it the frequency in kilohertz. If it is a microsecond, we need to give as a megahertz. If you're coming to the pulse generator, here you can set the pulse period in second. We know the frequency value. We say it is 25 kilohertz. Then 1 by frequency, 25,000. I will select it here. Then pulse width, how much I need to select a pulse width, whether it's a 40% or 80%, that we need to set it here. Then once you set this one, we need to give okay. Okay, okay. Whether we need to give any delay or... Once again, it is changing. Okay, I'll be connecting. 1 will be 25,000. Now this will be 40. Okay, press OK. Then it will be connected. The inductor value is selected. Then capacitor value also selected. The resistance value also selected. The input voltage. Input voltage I will give 12 volt. I want to make as a boost values. 12 volt I will give. Then 12 volt input I have given. Also, some more parameters are given in the switching devices, in diode as well as in the MOSFET. Many parameters are given. You can leave as it is. Okay, if there is a FET resistance R on, then internal diode resistance L on, diode inductance L on. These are the parameters will be given. This and all will be based on the data sheet values. If you are choosing a particular component, based on the data sheet values, we need to feed these values. Here, if you're coming to this FET on resistance, you can vary this value. It should not be zero. While we keep the inductance value zero, the resistance value is not to be zero. That is based on the component design. Okay, it should be, we can, if you want to make an ideal MOSFET, we can type this is 0.001 also, we can select in the resistance. Here also, we can select diode also. Internal diode resistance also we can select likewise. Okay, here I am not disturbing anything. Now we will simulate this simulation, boost converter. Okay, before simulating, the graphical user interface, okay, our GUI is missing here. Okay, that is used to select your simulation, whether it is a continuous mode of simulation or discrete mode of simulation or pulse mode of simulation. That can be selected through the graphical user interface. Only if you are selecting the graphical GUI, Power GUI, then only it will be running, your Simulink will run. Okay, that the components will be interfaced in that. Then you can go to the component selection. Then you can come to SimPower system. Then here you can select power GUI. Okay, there is many option in power GUI. Okay, no need to connect this simulation, it will automatically check. Then here you can select which mode, which simulation type you want to select, whether it's a continuous or discrete or phasor mode of simulation. Okay, any of you know what is the difference between continuous or discrete or phasor simulation? Do you have any idea? Okay. See, if you want to get a smooth graph, okay, if you are getting a, if you want to get a sinusoidal graph, that time we will go for a continuous. Okay, if even sinusoidal waveform, if it is a step step pulses, that time we will go for a discrete. Then only if you want to get on and off, the in even in sinusoidal, if you want to get on and off, that time we will go for a pulse mode of GUI. Now for this we will get a waveform. Okay, the output voltage we will get it as a waveform. Then we will leave as a continuous GUI. Then I will select the simulation time. Okay, how much time I need to simulate? I will give 1 second of simulation time. As we know, we are given in kilohertz, 25,000 kilohertz, 25,000 hertz is given. Then if you want, it want to execute till 10 second means it will take lot of time. That is the reason. In 1 second itself, we have a mini division. That is the reason we will be taking this as 1 second. Based on your switching frequency, we need to be. Now I'll run this simulation. Then on pulse generator, we given the value. Now I'll run the simulation. We need to check the values. What is the voltage? What is the current? Okay. Now, if I open this simulation, then we have an option, auto scale option. Even in the auto scale option, we are not getting the proper output. If you are not getting the proper output, here we need to check the data limit. Okay. If you set the data limits, you won't get the proper output. Here, we need to remove this data limits. Okay, because you can select settings and history. You can select data limit and unselect, uncheck this settings. Now, I'll run the simulation again. We will check the output. The input voltage is 12 volt. I've designed, okay, I told you this is, I'm designing for a 20 volt, but what is the output we are getting, that we will check it. We will give auto scale. We are getting around 17. Okay, this I can say 17 to 18. Okay, this value is 18. It is settling. Okay, this is the value we are getting. Okay, there will be a oscillation. The output also, it will be gradually increasing. There is a overshoot, and there is a maximum peak. That and all, it is here in this simulation. If you want to avoid this, okay, if you want to avoid this, we need to go for a closed loop simulation. Okay, if there is a closed loop simulation, we need to take a feedback, and we need to have a controller. This and all we need to implement in this arrangement. Okay. This is a voltage. Okay, the voltage is 18 point something I'm getting. The input current of around 7 I'm getting. Then while I'm increasing the voltage, current should be decreased. See, the current should be decreased. The current value is 4.5. We can observe that while the voltage is increasing, the current is decreased. Okay, you can make a multiplexer. Okay, both the values we can compare. While we are going for, you are going for analysis. Okay, if you want to compare my input and output, you can use MUX. You can connect with one scope itself, then you can select it. Otherwise, if some uh, Here I will, here we will select a constant, then after constant, here we will give set point, then what is the set point we need to select, that and all we can give it here, like 5, 10, or what is the voltage we need to select. Okay, if you are going for a controller, if you are going for any PI, PID controller, we can give a per unit values. Okay, for selecting per unit values, we can choose a gain, then we can choose summing block. Okay, here we will choose a summing block. Okay, this will, I will give it to the summing block. This is my set point. Maximum my set point is 1. Then this will be connected from the output. This is my set point. This I can take it from the input. This I will take it from the, sorry, output. I will take it from the output. Then what is the output I required? Okay, that I should convert between 0 to 1. That is a per unit value. Here I will select. Here I will select. Then if I want to have a output voltage of 20, then I will select 1 by 20. Then I will give 20 here. Now here I need to design a controller as well as PWM generator. Based on the control, we need to select a PWM generation. For that, I will move this portion down. Okay, based on this. Now, there is a comparator. The constant input is given. Then comparator, almost we will be using positive and negative. Negative feedback we will use, positive and negative. You can double click on the comparator. We will give plus and minus. Then comparator is selected. Then we need to select a PID controller. Okay, any controller we can select based on the application. What is the load you are connecting? If you are connecting the motor load or battery application, what type of controller we need to select, that you need to analyze from the existing survey or what is the existing one. Based on that, you need to select. Then here you can select the controller. There is a continuous blocks. Here you can go for a PID controller. I will be selecting the PID controller. Okay, this is a PID controller, is sufficient. Now I will be selecting the PID controller. This I'm connecting here. After PID controller, this will take decision. Okay, we will give some set point here. Then this will take output from the output across the resistance. That will be a voltage that we are converting into per unit value. Then we need to choose the control option. Okay. If I'm getting these values, what is the, my controller gain? That and all we need to select from this. Then after controller, we need to have a PWM generator. Okay, you can come to the Simulink. Then SimPower system, you can come to SimPower system. Then pulse and pulse generation. Here you can select a PWM generator, DC to DC. This you can add here. Now you will be interfacing this one. What will happen? This will make a comparison. This will give a control signal. Based on the control signal, your PWM generator will be generating a pulse generator. Now, instead of this pulse generator, we can connect. Okay, we can connect this one. Okay, now we made this boost converter as a closed loop. Okay, we made this boost converter as a closed loop. Now we need to set the gain. Okay, what is the boost converter gain? That what is the PWM generator parameters? That and all we need to choose from this existing block. You can select a PID controller. Then this is one we need to design based on the model. Okay, we need to add this. We need to add this transfer function of PID controller. Based on the PID controllers, we have derived this value. This is 0.6, 0.7. Then this integral value is 100. Then what is a PID set point? Okay, we will set from the maximum upper limit is 1, then lower limit is 0.1 in the step size of 0.1. Sorry, 0.1. We will set it here. Then this and all no need to disturb. Okay. Here we will select PID values. Then okay. Now in the if we go for a controller, then next one PWM generator. What is the frequency? What is the frequency value that we need to set it here? That will be we need to set it here. That is frequency is 25,000. We need to give. What is the sampling time? That is 1 microsecond. We need to give 1 e power. What is sampling time? We need to consider when we will get a sampling time. Okay, if we go for a controller, then if it is taking as a sample, why not 2 microsecond or 3 microsecond? You can set. Okay, then accuracy will vary. Okay, then if you're going for a controller, that will be a digital one. Then we will select this sampling time. Then we have selected a sampling time. Then here we have selected a sampling time. This also we need to change. Then configuration parameters, we need to select discrete. Okay, already I told you. Then this one, we need to select a sampling time. The sampling time, this will be 1. Now we will give okay. Then you can give okay here. Now you can run this simulation. This way we made it as a closed. Okay, in this closed loop we can take for the your project. Okay, which the type of control you are using, whether it's a resistive load or inductive load, based on the application you can choose your controller. Now I'll run the simulation. Now you would have observed this one. Previously it is simulated very fast. While it is going for a closed loop, even in discrete mode it is taking some amount of time. Okay, even if we make this in continuous mode, it will take lot of time. Now we need to check the output. See, previously we have observed the output. What is the set point I have given in the controller? What is the set point I have given in the feedback is 20. Then if I change here, where I need to change, here I need to change. Then if I set as a 15, if I set as a 15, 1/15, I'll run this simulation. I need to get a 15. It's running, it will take some time. Let it complete. Okay, simulation completed. I'll open the scope. Now I'll put auto. See, the value is settling in the 15 because of improper choosing of the KPKI and the component. There will be some disturbance here. That should be, if you are designing carefully, we won't get this overshoot. Here we will get a maximum overshoot. Likewise, we are able to change the values. Okay, here we can change this to, I don't know whether it will boost till 25. We are given a 12 volt. Okay, I will do 25. This will boost because it's a simulation model. It will boost. It's compiling. Please. Now And even 25, we need to check whether we are getting 25. It's settling at 25. Okay, this is how we need to design a boost converter. Okay, the next portion. Okay, if you're coming to the next one, okay, you know how to select the component. You know when we have to go for a continuous mode of our GA, when we have to go for a discrete mode. The next one, we will go for a buck converter. I think I don't want to construct again. Okay, already constructed and get it ready. That one I will open. Okay, if I have a existing file, how to open that file? Okay, then you can go to the file, open, or you can select control O. Here itself it is specified control O. This itself, you can press control O. Then it will go to default place. Then you can go to the bug boost converter. Then here I made a bug converter in a closed loop as well as open loop. Then bug converter, I will open. Okay, this is a closed loop. Okay, here we didn't set a controller. Okay, in the previous case we used a PID controller, but in the case, in this case, we are not using a PID controller. Just we made a comparison, the constant values. Okay, the previous one we use a digital controller, that is PID controller. We use per unit values that we used to set in this. Okay, by considering this one, you can say there will be a drag this one here. See, this is for comparing the input and output voltage. I already told you. Here, this will get a input voltage. Here, we will get output voltage by using a mux. We will connect it to the scope. We will get a input voltage as well as output voltage. Here, directly we are taking the output voltage. Here we are taking the directly output voltage that we are giving to the comparator. Is this visible to you? Okay, this will be giving to the comparator. Then we will set the constant value. The voltage will be 12 volt. Then based on the design, okay, based on the circuit is constructed, then the resistance value and the MOSFET. See, the MOSFET is given. The switching pulse, okay, see, the switching pulse given to the gate terminal. Then we didn't made any changes. I didn't made any changes here. The same thing only I'm proceeding. This I'm giving to the gate terminal. Then inductor value of 12.15 microhenry. Then the capacitance value of 3.75 microfarad. Then resistance of 1 ohms. Okay, according to this buck converter design, I'll be choosing these values. After choosing these values, we will take the output. Okay, we will take the output that is given to the comparator. Based on the compared values, we will generate a PWM. Okay, then what is the switching frequency that I'll be giving here? That is 400 kilohertz. That is the switching frequency we will give it here. Then I will set the output voltage as 5. Okay, then I will set it 5. Now we will run this simulation. Okay. Let it complete. Okay, this is in the case of closed loop buck converter. If I don't want to have a closed loop, instead of this comparator block, you can have a PWM generator. Okay, then the pulse generation, you can add it here. Then if I want to have a controller, that you can add it here. The controller, you can add it here. That will be connected before the PWM generation. Now I've given constant voltage of 5 volt. See, it is around settling 5 volt. Okay. Now, if I change the values to 8, I'll run the simulation. Let it complete. Sure. Given the constant value of 8, then I will see the output. I will observe the output. You can observe this is around it setting 8. If you give a controller, if you give a controller that gain values of controller, if you are choosing properly, or any fuzzy based controller or some other controller, you are going for a it is a resistive load. Then we will use a PID controller itself. Then we will set the gain values, we will get the correct output, the bug output we will get. Okay, by this combination, okay, the bug and boost combination, we will make a next converter, third converter, and remaining converter control. With this arrangement, we will change the arrangement of switching and inductor connection. We will make. Now, next one, we will discuss bug boost converter. Even the same component only. Okay, you do you have any doubt in this component selection or any other doubt? You can discuss with me. Parallel, I'll open this bug boost converter. I'll open the bug boost converter. Okay, I'll be opening the bug boost converter. Bug boost. I will open. Okay, this is the bug boost converter. This we made it in the open loop. Okay, we didn't make a closed loop. If you want to have a closed loop, you can make the closed loop. The parameter values, whatever I've taken for this simulation is, this is 48 volt I given. I need to get, okay, here you can see, I need to get the bug boost converter. I need to get a value of, you can see here, what is the input I given? See, the input I've given here is 48 volt. Then I want to get a 24 volt bug output or 70 volt boost output. For this arrangement, for this requirement, I've taken this this other component. Okay, the inductor value of 10 milliampere, then capacitance of 470 microfarad, in the resistance of 2 ohms, then switching frequency of 10 kilohertz. Then duty cycle is important. Okay, as you know, the converter, this converter will be operated in boost and buck mode. When it will operate in boost mode, when it will operate in buck mode? When the bug boost converter will be operated in boost mode? Okay, it will be operated in a boost mode and bug mode based on the duty cycle. If less than 50%, it will act as a bug mode. Greater than 50, it will be acting as a boost mode. That we will observe. So this bug boost converter, this bug boost converter, here we will design the same component. Okay, this is the inductance value of 10 millihenry, then the capacitance, then the capacitance of 470 microfarad, sorry, 470 microfarad, the resistance of 2 ohms, then the pulse generator value 10 kilowatts, then initially I will give pulse width of 35%. Yes, initially we will give 35%. Here I'll be giving 35%. Then voltage, voltage I am giving as a 48 volt. Okay, now I will run this simulation. Okay. What is the output I need to get? Okay, then based on the variation of duty cycle, the output will vary. You see, I'll make a auto scale. See, the output is coming as a negative. It is negative something 24. It's coming. See, you need to observe one thing here. What is observation you need to make? Okay. See, this will be inverting converter. While is explaining about buck boost converter, the power flow. This will be the current flow will be this direction. It will be from the reverse opposite direction. That is the reason capacitor I have reversed here. Then we will get a voltage. The probe of voltage measurement is connected top of the resistor and bottom is connected negative. But the output what we will get here in the bottom we will get a positive. That is the reason our output will be coming as negative. Okay, for this duty cycle, okay, 35 I'm getting 24 volt. If I set 30 percentage of duty cycle pulse width, then what is the observation we can check? See, 30 percentage, if I'm decreasing the duty cycle, here it is around 18 volt. We are getting around 18 volt. See, while I'm giving 48 volt, the voltage is 48 volt, the pulse width I'm giving less than 50, what is my voltage? You can see the voltage, here we are giving a voltage of 48, the output we are getting with 35, we are getting 24, with 30, we are getting 18. The pulse, the output is decreasing. The voltage, input voltage is 48, output voltage is less than the input voltage. Now this is operating in the buck mode. Okay, now we can move to the next. When it will operate in boost mode, while we are increasing the pulse width. Okay, if I'm increasing the pulse width, if I'm giving a pulse width of 70, already I've given 35, I'm giving a 70. I've given 70 for this buck boost converter, 70% duty cycle. I'll run this. Now, see the voltage. You see the voltage? It is reaching around 75. See, reaching around 75. The voltage is reaching around 75. Okay, now you would have observed. Okay, the voltage you would have observed. This will be acting as a input voltage is 48. Output we are getting is 75, around 75. It is not settled. Even it in 0.1 second, it is not settled. It is till it's continuing. You can set the simulation stop time 1 second. You can observe this where it is settling. That you can observe, okay, by increasing the stop time. I think it's completed. Now we will open this. Okay. See, around 80 only it's settling. Now by increasing the duty cycle. Okay, see the pulse width. This will be acting as a boost converter. This is about a boost converter, buck converter, and buck boost converter. Likewise, we can connect the remaining component and we can practice and talk. If there is any doubt or anything, we can discuss in the afternoon. If you have any doubt, whatever we have discussed till now, you can post it in chat window or you can ask.
So if there are any questions from the audience side, you can put it in the chat box. So there are no questions. So.
Okay. Even if you have any doubt, you can come in the afternoon session. We will discuss. Okay, with this, you can complete the session.
Sir, there is a question.
Yes, I read the question. Okay, the continuous and discrete. Okay, here itself I told you, even I will share for better understanding, I will share my screen. See, you know the output. Okay, here what is output we are getting? This will be. This is a output we are getting. Okay. In some case and all, for some case and all, we will get output like this. We will get a output like this. Okay. We will get a output like this. If I want to get a smooth output, that time I will go for a continuous one. Even if you are getting this type of output, that time if you are changing to discrete, what will happen in your I'll change the color. See what will happen if you are in the continuous selection, the GUI, if you are in the operating in the continuous, you will get out. Then if you are going for a discrete, okay, you will be getting the output like this. Okay, the samples will be taken. Okay, number of samples per second. That is the one we are given, 1 microsecond. Then how the samples will be taken. This is in the case of discrete. The green one is for discrete. The red one is for continuous. If you are considering continuous and discrete, which mode of simulation will simulate very faster? See, if you are going for a discrete mode, this will simulate faster. Okay. It will take more sample. It will take discrete sample. It will take more time. Now, if you're going for a pulse mode, okay, the other mode is pulse mode. In the case of pulse mode, what will be your output? You are able to get the maximum values. You will get a maximum values, maximum and minimum values alone. You will get it as a output. This is a different between. These are the difference between continuous and discrete and pulse mode. Any more question? Okay. Even you can give the output. This you can generate a sinusoidal output. You can select the same sinusoidal output generation. You can select your power GUI in different mode. While you are measuring voltage, you can select a different mode. You can observe this. What is the variation in the output? Any other?
Okay. Any other doubts you have?
Okay, any other question?
Rahul?
Yes, sir. Can we start the next session?
We'll start by 1 o'clock. We'll complete this session now. Okay. If there are no questions. Sir.
Yes, sir. I can see only the one question which Dominic sir just answered.
Okay, then you complete this session. We'll start the next session by 1 p.m.
Okay, sir. So with this, we are going to conclude the morning session. So at 1 p.m., we'll be starting with the afternoon session. So I thank Balaji sir and Dominic sir and all.